Thank you, Mr. Chair. Ilang katanungan lamang para sa ating Chief PNP. Last September 15, I sent a letter to your office and also to General Agustin of the PNP Cybercrime Office requesting on a report on your implementation of RA 10175 or the Cybercrime Prevention Act. One of the reasons I sent that letter is because Interpol reported an alarming rate of cyber attacks during COVID-19 pandemic. On a global scale, maraming nabibiktima ang cyber criminals sa pamamagitan ng online scams, phishing, identity theft, at fake news, at misinformation. Hindi lang mga individual users ang nabibiktima. Ayon sa kanila, maging ang mga malalaking korporasyon, mga pamahalaan, mga critical infrastructure ay nabibiktima din. They are also projecting further increase in cybercrime in the near future. Further, NBI said that phishing cases increased by 200%. Along this line, DOJ also reported a nearly 270% increase in the number of reported online sexual exploitation of children during three-month quarantine period. Having said that, I hope that the PNP will send their reply soon to my formal request for a copy of their report on the implementation of the Cybercrime Prevention Act. Everything is shifting to online and virtual, at lalo pang napapabilis itong shift dahil sa pandemya when everyone is at home. Pati nga mga transaksyon at libangan naging online na. Dahil dito, napakarami mga predators na ang nagsulputan. All it takes is for you to go online at kitang-kita ang talamak na kalokohang nangyayari for scams, for illegal raffles and gambling, to online falsities, and to the more serious online violence. Kahit nga bentahan ngayon ng illegal drugs at ibang pinagbabawal na epektos, online na rin. Unahin na muna natin itong online falsities na tinatawag ng karamihan na fake news. Pero sa katotohanan ay mas malalim pa kaysa sa fake news ito. Hindi lang kasi fake news ang pinepeke nito. This involves the faking and stealing of identities and willful and deliberate spreading of falsehood and lies with the purpose not only to mislead but to cause general confusion and sometimes fear. Meron bang pag-aaral at report ang PNP kung gaano na po kalaganap itong online falsity sa ating bansa at kung sino ang nasa likuran nito? PNP Chief, General Cascolan, may answer.
Yes, sir. With respect to Secretary Anyo, sir, may I answer your question?
Yes, go ahead. Yes, sir. General Cascolan.
Your Honor, it's very, very true. What the Senator said was very true. And as of now, even though with a lot of operations and accomplishments that we have done, there are still a lot of scammers and at the same time predators in the cyberspace. Basically, it's not just units or organizations that have been hacked, but even individuals have been hacked and been created fake Facebook accounts and whatever. But considering that we are right now in the IT age, sir, the cybercrime together with ITMS or the Information Technology Management System is trying its best really to fight cyber crimes. In fact, we have conducted a lot of operations from July 2019-2020 with more or less 214 operations, and we have arrested 252 individuals. Also, seven minors were rescued during this period. Among the highlights of the corporations are the arrest of a Nigerian who has amassed millions of pesos from the Filipino victims through the romance scam, and the arrest of a con artist who has been fraudulently milking money from high-profile individuals such as Senator Bongo by assuming identities of lawmakers. With this, sir, we have actually alerted all our anti-cybercrime units to monitor at least the cyberspace, the public cyberspace, so that we will be able to come up with an evaluation, proper monitoring, and the best what we call the cyber patrol, and the best initiative that we would be able to at least minimize the cyber crimes in space.
Yes, kakayahan ba ang PNP to identify these people, to anticipate na mas lalala pa ito because of the technology and circumstances? What proactive programs have you put into?
Actually, sir, we have what you call the cyber patrol. Okay. But in as much as we are concerned, to be frank with you, sir, we are even being hacked by a lot of hackers outside of the organization.
Hindi maganda yung nangyayari na yan. So,
opo.
You have to do something about this. Go ahead, continue.
Yes, sir.
Sir, we requested funds.
We requested funds, actually, sir, from your office for the cybercrime development
capability.
And enhancement capability in the amount of 385 million more or less. And we're hoping that you would be able to help us, sir.
Nandiyan ang
thank you very much, sir.
Medyo ano. So we move forward. We'll talk about the budget later, no? We move forward to more serious online violence. This is when technology, anonymity, and platforms are weaponized and used to target particular individual, organization, or a class of people. This goes beyond cyber bullying, no? Just recently, nating napakarami ang nagsasampa ng reklamo sa iba't ibang law enforcement agencies natin, punctuated by personalities who have fallen victim themselves. Dami na nagreklamo dyan, mga beauty queen pa iba, no? But ang grabing bastusan sa social media platform, iba't ibang klaseng kahalayan ang nandyan, tapos mga banta ng panggagahasa, pananakot, pananakit, blackmail, pag-uudyok para magpakamatay ang isang individual. Prostitution, napakarami pang krimen nandyan sa Facebook na nangyayari. Just imagine if you were a parent of a 14-year-old girl, tapos yung anak mo, pinadadalhan ng messages, comments na re-raping siya. That is prevalent now. Can you give us an idea sa trend ng mga kaso involving online violence, let's say, past 3 years, ano po ang mga status ng kasong ito, Chief Escolan?
Mr. Chair, we will give you the data as soon as we would be able to get it. But may I also state, sir, that we are closely monitoring together with the DICT. We have close coordination and cooperation with the DICT and other IT company so that we would be able to cope with the capability of basically knowing or patrolling the cyberspace. We hope, sir, that we would be able to develop more of our capability in cybercrimes, against cybercrimes, I mean.
That's right. Nandiyan pa rin yung mga online gambling, nandiyan yung illegal drugs, di ba, Chief?
Yes.
Yung online selling scam, sa tingin ko, pinakamarami na nagaganap ngayon, ito yung online scam. This is more serious that it appears dahil involved dito yung mga identity theft when sellers steals the identities of people para makapag-transact. Tapos maglalaho na lang at iba na ang mapagbibintangan. We really have to do something about this, General Cascolan, no? Marami mga reports na sa isang tao lang nakakapanloko ng milyon collectively, no? Then there are reports na pag nagsumbong sa pulis, sasabihin lang ng pulis ay wala tayong magagawa diyan dahil wala tayong kakayahan. I think we really have to do something about this. That's why, Mr. Chair, ni-raise ko ito dun sa cybercrime. I think we really need to give them a budget. Alam ko ang problema natin ito ngayon, ang hinaharap natin itong pandemya. Pero itong cybercrime, ito yung actual, ito yung makabagong panahon na problema natin. Pero I don't think that we can provide that much money now na 300 million as needed. Pero siguro po pwede niyong i-itemize yan, General Pascolan, na mas mababa, no? Na ano ba yung immediate na kailangan lang para mahabol natin itong criminal na ito at mapanagot natin sa ating batas, no? Sa hukuman. At we should not allow these people na manatili yan dyan. Dahil sobra na ang mga panggigipit nila at wala na sa lugar. At yun lang, I think I have here yung request ninyo for software, social media monitoring, cyber terrorism response. Nandito yung ICT machinery and equipment. Total of 31 million. Siguro, ito siguro, for the meantime, magagawa ng paraan ng ating chairman nito, no? Siguro mahanapan natin ng pondo. Huwag naman yung 300 million. Siguro itong ganito, siguro kung ganito po, pwedeng mag-boss-boss tayo sa iba para mabahagian natin at mabigyan natin ng solusyon itong problema sa online, itong cyberbullying na ito. At before I end, Mr. Chair, I just spread into the record my full support to the budget of DILG, now more than ever, considering the COVID-19 pandemic. We need to strengthen and capacitate DILG and its attached agencies with the budget they fully need. May I also put into the record my unwavering support in augmenting the budget to counter cyber crimes. Chief PNP, General Pascolan, you have my word that I will push for and facilitate the request of the PNP Anti-Cybercrime Office for additional budget. At hindi tayo pababayaan ng ating makisig na Senador Sani Angara. And sa inyo po lahat, maraming maraming salamat. Marami na ako binibigay ng sakit na ulo sa'yo, Padre. All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Senator Bong, and we appreciate the points you made. Tama ka, cybercrime is talamak talaga ngayon at it's the new battlefield that we have to equip our law enforcers. You made a very good point.